Hi there, I'm Chihiro from Japan. Welcome back to the program. Let's learn a life lesson from a story together. Have you all experienced heartbreak at some point in your life? I'm sure everyone has gone through it at least once or twice. When we experience heartbreak, we tend to bottle up our feelings and become overwhelmed with emotions like, I'm in shock and can't get over it, or it's so painful, I can't bear it. So, what can we do to get through this kind of emotional state? Today, I'll be discussing ways to overcome heartbreak. Honestly, there is no solution to this. There is no fix for heartbreak. As you all know, heartbreak is just something we can't fix. However, as time goes by, the painful feelings will surely fade. I'm sure that the painful, difficult state won't last more than 3 years. Over time, the pain will definitely fade. It's a different story if we can completely forget about it, but it's certain that the peak period of intense pain will eventually come to an end. This is similar to a storm. Just as a storm will pass with time, so will your heartache. Being outside during a storm is dangerous, as there is a high risk of being involved in an accident. We are powerless against the weather. It's the same with heartbreak. We can't do anything about it with our own strength. So we must endure it silently. As time passes, these feelings will calm down eventually. It's important to imagine that and endure it. The more we struggle, the more painful it becomes when we are carrying deep sadness. The truly painful period doesn't last very long. Please remember that this period won't last forever and do your best to get through the most painful moments. After that, it will definitely get easier. We use the term trauma to refer to past experiences that were extremely difficult or painful. The memories of past experiences cause us pain when they are remembered. So, how can we resolve this trauma? Let me explain it in a way that's easy to understand. Assume you had a breakup. Don't you do something like this? First, you speak to your coworker over lunch and say, I got dumped. The next day, you have some tea with a friend from your college days and say, I got dumped. And then, the day after that, you talk to a yoga friend and say, I got dumped. Don't you talk about your painful experience with someone every day like this? If you do, what happens? The experience becomes ingrained in your memory. Repeating the same thing 3 times makes it stick in your memory. Have you heard of this as a method of learning? It's the same thing. When you talk, you first vocalize the words, then you listen to the words with your ears, and then as you talk while remembering the situation, the memory of the heartbreak becomes firmly ingrained in your memory. You want someone to listen to you. If you just think about it on your own, you'll start to cry. That's why you talk about it. I understand that feeling, but that can actually be making you more painful. So, what can you do? Can't you talk to anyone about it? Thanks for subscribing to my channel. Let's get started then. So, what should we do in this case? The answer is to find someone you trust and talk to them about your heartbreak thoroughly. Do it only once. Take time to talk to someone you trust, and after that, don't talk about it anymore. You'll find that your healing process will be quicker than you expected. It's better not to talk to everyone you meet about that matter. It's important to have that $1 conversation. Heartbreak is sad and takes time to move on, but it's a waste to be controlled by its trauma and unable to move on to the next relationship. Don't feel down because someone rejected you. It doesn't mean you're not charming because your partner got someone else to love. There is no need to try hard to win back their feelings just because they got tired of you. It may be sad now, but look at it from a broader perspective. If you clearly did things that the other person didn't like or pushed your ego, then reflect on that. If you don't do that, the same outcome will just be repeated with your next partner. Otherwise, there's no need to blame yourself too much. A relationship is formed when two people are compatible. The person you love chose someone else because they are more compatible. Being turned down doesn't imply you lack charm. It simply means the other person wasn't the right fit for you. Rejection, in this case, provides an opportunity to find someone more compatible. I often emphasize how today's actions shape your future. Conversely, focusing too much on the past won't lead to a positive future. You may feel overwhelmed with why or how now. But in any case, endure the most difficult time now. Time will surely solve everything. You may feel like there's no good future ahead and that you can't look forward to anything. But did you know that 90% of human anxiety is about future events that haven't happened yet? Most of our worries are about things that haven't happened yet. Aren't you thinking about things like this? What should I do if I can't get married? What should I do if I don't have enough money when I'm older? You're getting anxious now by thinking more and more about things that haven't happened yet. It's good to think about the future, but overthinking isn't helpful. Focusing on the present is important. No one knows what the future will be like. It's more important to ask yourself if you had a good day today than to worry about the future. enjoy today. What? You can't enjoy today because you have a broken heart? You can't have a positive outlook on this? Well, let me explain further. We often hear someone say that they like someone who is cheerful or have a lovely smile. But not everyone is cheerful, and we often hear people say they want to be more cheerful. However, it's rare for cheerful people to say they want to be more negative. Can you change your personality? The conclusion is that it's not easy to change your personality, but it's possible with effort. How do you judge other people's personalities? You can't tell someone's personality right away unless you're highly intuitive or perceptive. You judge it based on their words and actions. It's important to know that you don't need to change your personality, but you should focus on changing your behavior. That's what you can do from today. By changing your behavior, you can change the impression and personality people see in you. Just by changing your behavior a little and being more conscious of it, you can become closer to your ideal self. I've talked about specific ways to change your behavior in a previous video, so please check it out. Hopefully this video is helpful to you. Well, that's about it for today's episode.